Hello everyone, this is Harsh and you are watching WPF World. Welcome to another series of WPF tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn how to connect SQL Server to WPF application. And also we will learn the CRUD operation using SQL Server. So without wasting time, let's get started. In the last video, I have created the employee table. And now I want to modify the table according to our registration form. So I will add some more column into the table. Let's add it. Now I will go to Visual Studio and I will click on Tool menu and select Connect to Database. Here I will set server name as dot for local server and I will choose the database from the list. Now I can test the connection using Test Connection button. Now the connection is successful. We can now write the code for CRUD operation. So let's jump into the code and write the code for all the button. First I will write the code for register button. So it will insert the data into the table. I will add click event for register button. Here I will write code for register button. For that we have to create the SQL connection object. And here we have to pass the connection string of the database. How to pass the connection string? Go to database and right click on the database and select the property. Here you can see connection string. You can just copy this text and paste into this constructor. Now we have created the SQL connection. To insert the data into table, we have to open the connection first. So we can write connection.open. Now we have to create the command for inserting data into the table. For that, we have to create the object of SQL command and we have to pass the command into the constructor. Here I will pass insert into command. We can write insert into table name, which is employee, and then all the column name inside the bracket and then values. After that we have to pass the value for all the column. We have to pass the parameter for all the column name. How to pass that? We have to use the @ symbol and that parameter name. Like this we can pass. After that we have to add the parameter to the command using addWithValue method. Here we can pass parameter name and then the value. As we have to pass the value for empid, so I will take the text from txt empid text box. Like that we can add parameter for all the column. For the gender option, we have the radio button. And here I want to convert radio button is checked to male and female. If we select male radio button, then it should show male. Means it will add male to the table. So I have added the logic here. Male radio button is checked, then it will be male. Otherwise, it will be female. And for the date of birth, I have converted text to date time. And for employee ID, we have converted text to integer type because all the value which is inside the text box will be of string type. So we have to convert text to integer because I have created the employee ID column as integer. I will add one item to the combo box. Means for country, I have added India. After adding all the parameters to command, we have to execute the command using execute nonQuery method. Now let's run and see the result. Let's input all the value and click on register button. Here if you see this selected item value, it is combo box item type. So we have to convert to string type. So I will remove this combo box item from here and directly I will put India here. Here the exception thrown because of this source property of the image. So now we have to convert this source to string type. Here I will convert source to string using toString method. Now let's run and see the result. We can see the updated value in the table. Let's see. I will run select star from employee here and we can see here the value is inserted here and you can see all the value like address is India, country is India, gender is male and the photo URL is this. For now, I will remove this upload photo section and I will add some more button for the CRUD operation like how to get the record, how to insert the value, how to delete the value, and how to update the value of this record. Let's add and see. I will add click event for all the button so that we can write the logic inside the click event to do the CRUD operation. Now I will add the logic for get detail of the employee in the get detail event, get detail click event. For that we need the SQL connection as well as SQL command. In the SQL command we have to use the select query. I will pass the select query in the select command. I want the record from the table based on the employee ID. So I will pass the employee ID parameter. For that we need the EMP ID parameter. So for that we will use @EMP ID and we will add the condition where EMP ID equal to @EMP ID. And now I will add the parameter using addWithValue method. As we want to read the value of the employee, so we have to use the executeReader method to get the detail of the employee. Once you call the executeReader, you will get the result, and here we will read in the loop. In this case, the employee which have the ID as EMP ID will get the record of that employee. And we can read the value of the column using reader, and inside the square bracket we have to pass the column name. And we can convert this to a string so that it will be available in our text box and other control in UI. And we can see all the value from the table of that employee ID. Here I have to add the logic for radio button because we will get the string value from the table. So we will check if gender equal to male, then male radio button will be checked, otherwise female radio button will be checked. Now let's run and see the result. We are getting this error because we have not generated the click event for update and delete button. So let's generate it. Now let's run and see the output. Here I want to get the record of the employee ID with ID 1. So here I will pass 1 as EMP ID and will click on get details. Here we are getting the exception because the select keyword is wrong. So let's fix it and run it again. Now let's enter 1 and click on get details. See, all the details are available in all the controls. Now let's add the logic for update button. Here I copied all the statement from the registered click event. And now I will update all the required statement. I will update the required statement for updating the table. So we have to change insert into command to update command. We will say update employee set EMP ID equal to @EMP ID, which is parameter we want to pass. Means we want to update EMP ID based on EMP ID. So we will pass all the parameter using addWithValue. And again we have to add the logic for male and female radio button. Let's add it and execute this query. Here we are getting this photo URL error because I have commented this photo URL. Now we don't have upload photo controls in the UI, so we don't want to pass this value to the table. So I will pass empty value for now, because if we don't pass value for any column, then we will get this kind of exception. Here I want to update the employee with employee ID 1. So I will enter employee ID as 1 and will click on get detail. We will get all the detail of the employee ID with 1. And now I will update the name and click on update button. It will update the value of the employee ID. Now let's see in the table. I will again run the select query in the table, and now let's see, because both employee have the same ID, that's why all the employee name updated to capital Kumar. I will copy this statement and I will paste into the click event, and here I will update the query for deletion of the record. So here I have to pass the query as delete from employee, where employee ID is EMP ID. And now as this is for deleting the record, so we have to execute this command using the execute none query method. So let's run and see the result. Here I want to delete the record of employee whose employee ID is 1. So I will enter employee ID as 1, will get the detail and click on delete button. For now we have two records of employee with employee ID 1. So let's click on delete and let's again execute this query in the database. See, all the records are deleted now because both employee ID had employee ID as 1. Now I will add the confirmation message for all the events. Like if the value is deleted, if the record is deleted, then let's show successfully deleted. Like that, I will add for all the operations. Let's add and see the output. I hope you learn how to connect SQL Server database to WPF application, and also you have learned how to do the CRUD operation in WPF using SQL Server database. That's all for this video. If you found this video helpful, let's share with your friends.